You're listening to Civic Media. Stay up to date on the latest news and information for your local community and Wisconsin by signing up for our free email newsletter. Visit civicmedia.us/email to get started.
In my mind, I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Now can't you just feel the moonshine? And ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? Yes, I'm gone to Carolina in my mind.
It's supposed to be slow. No, it should be James
Karen,
Taylor.
She's a silver.
All right, welcome back to the Earl Ingram Show. As always, you can join us at 844-967-2789. You can text us at that same number. It's Friday. That means Friday's my co-host, Sandy Williams. So, Sandy, the music.
Well, the music is all the states that are swing states. That's about Carolina, James Taylor. It sounded more like the Chipmunks, though. I think it was somehow playing at the wrong speed. It was James Taylor in Carolina.
So we've been talking a little bit about my guest who is going to be coming up, Mr. Ken Blackwell. He's a former Ohio Secretary of State, America First Works for Donald Trump. He is the chair for election integrity. He's going to be joining us at 9:30, and so people have been weighing in. Let's go to Susan from Kenosha. Good morning to you, Susan. You say what?
Well, I say I'm glad that you're having him on. I think it is good for us to, as Americans, we need to listen to both sides. The left side doesn't always listen to the right side, and the right side doesn't always listen to the left side. But as Americans, we need to hear this. We need to know what is right and what is wrong. And when we have one side that continuously listens to rhetoric like the Fox News and those stations, they get inundated with propaganda and things that do not exist. So we on the left side, unfortunately, deal in fact, a lot of us, and you know me, I have to go to the book or I have to go to the computer. I have to find the facts. I have to find the numbers. And when I go into a conversation with anyone, I want a debate. I don't want propaganda. Show me your proof. You show me your proof, and I will look at it, read it, and if I understand it and you are correct, I will change my mind. But I am not going to change my mind for fear or any kind of things that you're going to throw at me, because I live in a common sense world and I live in a world that actually believes in truth. And this country does believe in truth and justice and a constitutional right. And my big fear with all this is that we're going to lose our constitution. I can stand losing an election, but I cannot stand by and let my constitution and my rights and the rule of law to leave this country. That, unfortunately, I'm not going to stand for. And I might be 74, but I'll fight every inch of the way to keep those. And I think that people don't understand this is what this is all about. This is a very important election. And we can't continue to fight like this.
Hey, Susan, thank you very much for the call. As always, I concur with you. Let's go to Gary from Sussex. Good morning to you, Gary. You say what?
Well, I'm glad you're going to be allowing conservative voices on the air.
Hey, like Gary, I always allow conservative voices on the air. I'm not like conservative stations.
Okay, and that's true. And that's why I like you as a person. I like your vigor and everything else. And I like the fact that you do allow me to come on the air without making me sit there for a half an hour like some of the other people do. But the one thing that Susan said is she wanted to know the truth. And the main reason or the main uh, excuse, topic of what's going on in this race is the abortion issue. And I am very strong against abortion, okay? Because I've seen what happens. I've held
Hey, Gary. My wife. Hey, Gary, let me ask
Let me just finish.
No, no, I can't let you finish. We're talking about something altogether different. You know, I mean, I don't mind having the conversations with guys on the other side. But, man, to come and change the subject matter is the issue. Right? I mean, we're talking about election integrity. And the fact that Republicans continue to say that it doesn't exist and that they feel that the elections, if Donald Trump loses, is going to be stolen. So, I mean, do you have an opinion on that?
Yeah. I always want to ask you, what are you afraid of that Donald Trump is going to do to get rid of democracy in this country? Just name one thing.
Okay, hey, Gary,
Wait.
Hold on, Sandy. First off, again, what is your thought about the election integrity and the fact that Republicans are still saying they're not going to accept the outcome of the election?
That's not true. I don't know anybody who's saying that they're not going
to
accept.
You don't have to know them. The FBI is saying that they're concerned. The FBI.
Well, actually, the candidate himself has refused to answer the question about whether he'll honor the outcome of the election. But Gary opened the door. I just want to answer his question because there are answers to that question. In Project 2025, and I know you'll say he disavowed it, they want to eliminate the 10-year term for the FBI and make him serve at the pleasure of the president. I assure you that Donald Trump would prefer that and would try to institute that. They want to make sure that the Justice Department carries out no prosecutions in the U.S. attorney's offices around the country as well as in the Justice Department that don't receive the approval of the president. That gives the president his own police force and his own enforcement mechanisms, okay? That's a terribly risky thing for our democracy. A private police force for the president and a prosecutorial process that's totally political. That it, in and of itself would mark the end of the constitutional democracy as we know it.
Yeah, but Sandy, do you between you and me, just you and me now, do you honestly believe that Donald Trump is supporting this Project 2025?
Absolutely. I absolutely believe it.
100% between you and me.
100% I believe it. And I believe it because he's said it. He had a meeting with the Heritage Foundation head several months ago and talked about how they were laying the foundation for the next presidency. And I also firmly believe that he would be strongly in favor of having the FBI director serve at his pleasure. He tried to do it. He tried to control the FBI while he was in office.
Hey, Gary, it can't be between you and Sandy on the Earl Ingram show and all the other listeners listening. Okay? So, again, changing the subject. So, you know, I mean, you seem to believe that apparently, because you haven't answered the question, whether or not the election fraud and all the different things that Republicans are talking about, the guy up in Warsaw, the mayor in Warsaw who removed the ballot box. For what reason? I mean, so many different things that Republicans have done to somehow mislead people to believe that there's all this election fraud.
Well, Gary, do you believe that non-citizens are voting around the country?
I do not know. I do know that if you end up getting a driver's license, that's all you have to show when you go out there and you make out your application for your voting, you know, certificate.
No, you have to.
All you have to do is show a driver's license
to register to vote.
Yeah, you can say that.
You need a driver's license to, once you're on the voting rolls, you need a driver's license to identify yourself at the ballot, at the place where you're voting.
You also, right. So you go, let's say let's say you're not registered. Let's say you move from California to Wisconsin. All you do is in Wisconsin, you go to your voting district, you show them your driver's license, you register to vote that day within a couple of minutes. That's so simple. Do I believe it's happening? Maybe. But the fear that I have, let's say that this mayor in Wausau, this voting box was not strapped down. Anybody could have taken that box and thrown it away.
Hey, Gary.
So he took it and he secured it. No, he put it in a secured place.
So the mayor has the authority to take the voter box because he feels that, you know, somebody can take it away. So he takes it away himself unilaterally, and those people of Wausau who want to use that box can't use it because the mayor unilaterally makes the decision to remove it. That makes sense to you?
Don't all they have to do is go inside or drop it in the mailbox right next to where the box was before. There's a mailbox right there. You can just drop it in the mailbox. They didn't have to put it in this special box.
Hey, Gary,
bolted down to the
thank you very much for the call. Sandy, there are these ballot boxes in different parts of the city. They're bolted down. They're bolted down for a reason, Sandy, because people like Gary and others will say, well, somebody can physically pick it up and take it somewhere else. Those boxes are, you know, pretty sturdy. And so not just anybody can pick them up and move them and take them anywhere. Plus, there's no proof that that's ever happened, Sandy. So how can you respond to the whims of each and every person, Sandy, who thinks that, you know, they come up with an idea and somehow that becomes fact? Well, we got to respond because somebody might pick up, you know, that ballot box and take it, you know, around the corner and then pull out the ballots and somehow that's cheating. I just don't understand why we keep responding to what I believe are just crazy thoughts of people because they want to make sure they win an election. That's what we're doing now. We're responding to all sorts of crazy things that people are saying, Sandy, and, you know, it's more than frustrating. 8445 7522 4842. All right, welcome back to the Earl Ingram Show. As always, you can join us at 855-752-4842 is the number. You know, we're a few minutes away from our conversation with Ken Blackwell. And so we've, again, been, you know, for the life of me, it is, I got to tell you, it's frustrating when we have callers call in and change and want to change the subject. You know, we clearly have subjects that we have chosen that we're going to be talking about. And so it's not a free for all. So for you to call and change it at your whim is, you know, that means it's just not going to work. anymore. Again, 855-752-4842. Let's go to Brendan from New Jersey. Go ahead, Brendan.
Yeah, I just wanted to remark on what North Carolina has recently done by removing 740,000 voters off their rolls, only for the reason that they didn't vote in the last two general elections. Well, what if there wasn't a candidate they wanted to vote for? Or what if they just abstained from voting altogether? You're not supposed to be able to remove people from the voters' rolls. So if anybody in North Carolina is listening, you better make sure you're still registered if you didn't vote in the last two elections. The other states who are now trying to put in laws that are making it harder for poor people to vote by getting a photo ID. Poor people a lot of times can't. A, they sometimes don't have driver's licenses because they don't have cars, but they still pay taxes and they're still entitled to vote and they're still citizens. Or states that are trying to adopt laws where you have to prove you're an American citizen. Your ID is no longer good enough. So now you got to go dig out your birth certificate and carry it to a polling place with you. And then there are closing polling places. We know that. Does everybody forget about these voter registration boxes where we had knuckleheads from the right sitting with AR-15s right next to the voting boxes, and people were intimidated, older people were intimidated to go and drop their ballots in? All this stuff is going to all come about again, and everybody needs to be aware of it. That's all.
Hey, Brendan, thank you very much for the call. I mean, let's just be clear and honest about what's been transpiring in this country since Republicans have made these allegations that are unfounded, that can never be corroborated and backed up with fact. You know, I've been voting, 52 years. I've never missed an election. I don't care what it's for. And so, just because somebody in their minds for their own reasons want to change and challenge everything that's worked for so many decades in this country as it relates to our elections are not puppet elections. It doesn't matter whether people on the right want to continue to say this. We're responding to all of those things based on what somebody is feeling, and they feel like somebody is cheating. My biggest issue with all of it is, since when do we start responding to what somebody, because somebody feels a certain way? You know, many immigrants are voting illegally. Well, can you back it up? Well, I just feel like that's happening, Sandy. When did our nation start moving based on what somebody's feelings were?
Well, Donald Trump's approach since 2016 has been to talk about his intuition, his gut, what he thinks might be the case, what could happen. It could happen, you know, the mail-in ballot could be used fraudulently by so many people. Well, you know, we've had many, many adjudications, many courts looking at this, investigations in a variety of states that have cost millions of dollars, people who have made these allegations trying to establish them. And they wouldn't be difficult to establish if they were true, but they can't establish them because it turns out that all this worry about election integrity is ill-founded and is really just it's a red herring. It's designed to create a smell that takes everyone off the track.
For heaven's sakes, you're an attorney. You know our elections are the safest in the world. They've always been that way, right? Is it safe to say that?
Well, you know, there's stories, machine politics in cities, long, there was a time. But the process has evolved with the numbers of checks and controls that exist at the polls, which anybody who works at the polls can tell you how absolutely impossible it would be to defeat all of those control processes and cheat. All right. You'd have to have a very big conspiracy with a whole lot of innocent people involved in order to accomplish it.
So I walk up, the same people that where I vote every all the time, they see me. How you doing, Mr. Ingram? They know who I am because I vote in every election. Can I see your driver's license? Okay. They know who I am. They don't just accept the fact that I'm Earl Ingram. Then they check. They know my address because I'm...
Well, and there's,
they check,
and there's two people
two
doing
people.
It.
Yes.
Yeah, there's an audit. I mean, it's a highly controlled process. And the fact is that litigation has proven that there's no lack of integrity across the board here that warrants the way the Republican Party has decided to treat it.
Well, Sandy, you know, you say there's no lack of integrity. Well, we're going to be joined by a guy whose responsibility for America First works. He's the chair of election integrity.
Well, he's the guy who keeps the elephants from invading. And the fact is, you don't see any elephants, right? It must be working.
All right. 855-752-4842. We'll be back.
You're listening to Civic Media. Find the latest news, information, and archives of all your favorite shows on the Civic Media website, civicmedia.us.
All right, welcome back to the Earl Ingram Show. As always, you can join us at 855-752-4842. That's 855-752-4842. It's Friday. That means Friday's with my co-host Sandy Williams. And I'd like to welcome Mr. Ken Blackwell. He's the former Ohio Secretary of State. He's now presently America First Works Senior Advisor and Chair for Election Integrity. Good morning to you, sir. How are you?
So good to be with you.
All right. So before we get started, my co-host Sandy Williams has a couple questions he wants to ask you, and then we will move forward. Sandy, you got a couple questions?
Well, I do. You're heading a group that's denominated Election Integrity, which begs the question of the notion that elections without a watchdog like your organization would operate without integrity. And I'm just wondering, you know, we've heard rhetoric during this election about illegal immigrants voting. Is there evidence of any substantial number of illegal of voting by non-citizens, immigrants, any place in the United States? No, I just answer the question, sir. Is there evidence?
What did I just say? I said yes.
Okay, where is that evidence, sir?
There are folks who, in fact, are now doing time for manipulating voter rolls and actually having folks who are
sure.
not eligible to vote.
Okay, all right. So I didn't ask, sir.
I don't care what you ask me. You invited me on the show, and let me give you the thinking behind my organization's operation.
Well, no, we invited you on, sir.
Do you want me to speak to
what I would like to understand without talking points is I'd like to understand the evidence that exists for the notion that there is substantial, not evidence that there is a singular case here or a singular case there, but that there is evidence that there has been a lack of integrity in the elections that have occurred in the last 10 years.
Mr. Blackwell, I think that's a fair question to ask, sir.
Fair question. And my answer is going to be a fair answer. He started out by asking me if there are any evidence. He just, in fact, confirm that there's evidence here, evidence there.
Right.
But what his argument is based on is that it hasn't hit a critical mass to impact a result.
That would be correct, though, right? That would be correct.
That is correct. That there's evidence that it has happened.
Well, I didn't.
There's no place where, in fact, it has been proven that it hit a critical mass that changed the outcome of an election.
Mm-hmm.
Here is one of the things, so that you understand the way I approach this, because I have administered elections, not only in my state, but I have chaired the International Foundation for Electoral Systems, and we have, in fact, not only observed, but advised elections across the globe. I was treasurer of the state of Ohio, and part of the responsibilities was to safeguard the retirement savings of our workers. I worked with banking systems across the country. One of the things that we did was not wait until there was a robbery or a theft of dollars to put in place things that safeguarded against those robberies forever taking place. The system was always, or the objective was to always stay in front of those folks who would do wrong and who would manipulate.
So let me
tell you the way that it approached, the way that this we approach this whole thing with voting, whether it is non-citizens or citizens who have not registered or who are, or for one reason or another, who are not eligible to vote. We, in fact, start with protecting the voter rolls to make sure that those folks in our voter rolls are folks who are citizens and eligible to vote. We, in fact, knew and know, just like Willie Horton, when asked why did he rob banks, he said because that's where the money is.
That was Jesse James, sir.
That was also Willie Horton.
Okay, but go ahead.
So the point being is that we have put in place safeguards against the manipulation of corrupted voter rolls, or safeguards that protect the integrity of citizenship and our system. And that's why we, in fact, have asked for voter IDs across the country, because we don't think that that's an intrusion or overly burdensome. And we think that is a great way of making sure that voters are who they claim to be. And so we can waste a lot of time talking about whether or not there is a critical mass that has historically proven that there are massive numbers of non-citizens voting.
Wait,
sir. Sandy, let them finish.
And it has had an impact on an election, or we can talk about taking prudent measures to make sure that that can happen, so that you, in fact, enhance the confidence of people in the process and you encourage them to participate.
So, sir,
I'm not here.
Sir. So, okay. So, you know, we got to have a conversation, meaning both sides. So my question to you is, where, as a 70-year-old man who's voted in all elections, and prior to Donald Trump and what happened, and what his beliefs are, that things are rigged, there was no such reality as, you know, voter integrity issues. Our nation and everybody was comfortable that what was taking place in this country was fair and above board. And so I never thought of that I had to worry about our elections. I always felt comfortable that the system was set up and it worked for all those years. But to somehow think that, you know, we have to make sure that nobody's going to cheat, as if somehow there are massive numbers of people who are cheating that's going to change the outcome of elections, is just not true, sir. And so I don't understand. You say we have to do preventative stuff, you know, to make sure that what we know is not happening overwhelmingly happens. I don't understand that.
What you're just saying is complete BS. Let me just take you back to 2004 when Ohio was the round zero. Do you know that there were folks who brought lawsuits against the state of Ohio because they said that there was a deliberate attempt to create long lines that would in fact suppress the turnout of black voters. So don't tell me that there's never been any firsthand. So don't tell me. Go back to 2001. Go back to there has never been in your lifetime an election that hasn't had questionable practices and challenge results. Never in your lifetime.
Don't tell me
that there's no reason that we can't continue to look for ways to improve a human enterprise.
Well, let me ask, irregularity free. Let me ask a question. In this last budget, this bill that was just passed a couple of days ago in Congress, there was an attempt to attach to it a rider that would require proof of citizenship to vote, and would outlaw non-citizens from voting, when in fact it's not allowed. In no state in this country is it allowed for non-citizens to vote in federal elections. Why did there need to be another round of federal legislation outlawing something which was already unlawful?
One, because you cannot, as for there in federal elections, there's a difference between what you can ask for complete federal elections to elect members of Congress, members of the Senate, and members of and the President of the United States.
Right.
Apart from states that have required certain voter identification policies and verification practices. And that's why.
Well, wait, this is kind of word salad. Exactly. This is word salad. It's already unlawful.
It's not word salad.
Yes. Okay. I mean, what is the reason that there was a requirement that there be an additional law passed making something unlawful, which is already unlawful?
Because what happens is, you can get a driver's license. You, in fact, can get an identification document that, in fact, qualifies you to drive in your state and also qualifies as an identification card to register to vote. Now, you don't have to be a citizen to get that. And so there's nothing wrong in basically saying that what you want is proof of citizenship, because what is in fact insufficient now is a driver's license, because a driver's license can be given to non-citizens.
Well,
so that's not word salad. That is just practice. And what you guys seems to want to do is, in fact, not respect that we have a very poor southern border. We have 10 million people, that's conservative, that are here illegally. Many of them can get driver's license, which can be used as the document
in the state
register to vote. Excuse me, sir. You know, I'm not here to argue about whether or not we have an open border in the South.
Well, you brought it up.
I'm not going to argue it with you. It's a fact.
Well,
it's a fact that we have 10 million.
Well, nobody's arguing that.
Let me just say that by juxtaposing that statement with voter integrity is to suggest that there has been, in your mind, a substantial number of people who have been illegally voting who are non-citizens, when there's no evidence of this whatsoever. Every state does require U.S. Citizenship to vote in federal elections, and each state decides how it is that they're going to implement that process.
So hang on, Mr. Blackwell, if you will. 855-752-4842. My guest is Mr. Ken Blackwell. He's a former Ohio Secretary of State, America First Works Senior Advisor, and Chair for Election Integrity. You're tuned into the Earl Ingram Show. It's Friday. It means Friday is my co-host, Sandy Williams. All right, welcome back to the last few minutes of the Earl Ingram Show. As always, you can join us at 844-967-2789, or excuse me, 855-752-4842. You know, Mr. Blackwell is no longer with us. I think he chose Sandy to turn tail and run. All you can do is offer, you know, opportunities for people who make claims and allegations to, you know, come on the air and not be this in the safe confines of what he's used to being around. So why even offer or, you know, put information out and say we want to come on different shows to talk about what it is we're supporting, and then you don't want any pushback?
Well, I think the important thing that he said was that there is no evidence that there has been any sort of voter integrity issue that has risen to the level of affecting an election, okay? Because that's quite the contrary to what it is that Donald Trump runs around talking about. He's talking about elections being rigged against him. He's talking about how he massively won the election that he lost in 2020. And furthermore, this is a bit like those jokes before he came on about the elephants, you know, what is this elephant repellent? Well, what do you have that for? Well, it works. You don't see any elephants, do you? I mean, what they're talking about here is essentially elephant repellent. We've got election processes, which certainly in Wisconsin have a high degree of audit, internal audits, internal controls. Anyone who's worked the poll understands the extent to which there are many controls associated with it. And our state constitution requires U.S. citizenship to vote, and there's no evidence whatsoever that we have any sort of significant number, if any at all, of non-citizens voting in the state of Wisconsin.
Well, you know, you heard him say that there's no proof that there are a lot, so what we're doing is we're trying to do preventative measures.
Keeping the elephants.
Well,
they've got elephant repellent, but I mean, and elephants are the Republican Party too, aren't they? So I guess it is elephant repellent. But the fact is that this is all an attempt to create some substance behind the whole "the elections are rigged against me" concept. And the rigging that Donald Trump talks about, you know, the elections are rigged, and then when the contested election goes to court and the court rules against him, the court is rigged, and everything is rigged. It's all rigged, and then the question is, who's doing the rigging? You know, where is this? And it's the deep state. You know, ultimately, it's an amorphous, It's an amorphous organization that isn't an organization. It's a movement. It's something that's amorphously in control and invidiously in control against the interests of Donald Trump and his group. It's the establishment, okay? So it's the ultimate anti-establishment thrust. The establishment is the one that's calling the shots, and we've got to get them, okay?
All right, let's go to Gene from Milwaukee. Good morning to you, Gene. How you doing, man?
I'm doing well, and you? You know, the thing of it is, if you really listen, people who cheat always accuse the other guy of cheating, and they do that loudly to where they overrule the voices of the people who are not cheating, and they believe that is being cheated. The only somebody that really cheat is the Republican Party. They jimmy rig districts to where they are guaranteed to win. The only somebody that I know that was caught down in Florida trying to vote twice was a Republican. So these guys, they can't win at the ballot box. So they resort to things like they are doing, accusing people that is rigged. You know, the thing of it is, if you get your butt kicked in the rain, you got whipped. So the Republican Party is a shrinking, old, white, methodologist, racist party people. And they are shrinking because the thing of it is, you've lost more rights under the Republican Party than you have any party that's ever been elected out there. And if you go all the way back to Ronald Reagan, every one of them has used, like the guy brought up, Willie Harden, every one of them has used racism to interject it in there to make white folks fearful of black people. But then when 9/11 hit, at the job that we had, every white foreman wanted us to, black folks, to pray. So I'm saying we shouldn't only want to come together around a tragedy. We are all American, but the only way that Republicans can win is they rig the system.
Hey, Gene, I wish I had more time. Thank you very much for the call. Hey, Bill, go ahead.
Good morning. Can you hear me okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tell Sandy I need 2 cases of the elephant spray. I want the BS fragrance. That's what I want out of it. And I like the idea. I think right now with the election, people would actually buy that stuff. I mean it. I know plenty of my friends would. But here's my point. Donald Trump has never won anything. He lost to Hillary in 2016 by 3 million votes, enough to tip it her way. How did he get in? The Electoral College. And somebody said, well, how did that happen? Well, the guy who had the answer, James Comey, he got fired. Now, if I'm wrong, guys, tell me. I'll hang up.
Hey, Bill, thank you very much. I'm sorry. Thank you, everybody. We're out of time. Sandy.
Well, I'm hurrying out to buy a Donald Trump watch. So speaking about things for sale, we'll talk about that next week.
All right. Thank everybody for a great week. Up next, Greg Bach and Jane Matinere on air. Thank you, Calvin, for a great week. You've been tuned into the Earl Ingram Show. Enjoy the beautiful weather.
I love the best, better than all I can see. Right in the heart of the Golden West. Home means Nevada to me. Right in the heart of the Golden West. Home means Nevada to me.
The national news cycle never stops, but it can be hard to find news about your local community. Civic Media is dedicated to providing quality local and state news coverage across Wisconsin. With the Civic Media app, you can get notifications about local stories that matter to you and your community. Find the free Civic Media app in your phone's app store and choose notifications from the menu to tell us what kind of news you want to hear about.